Children, in this video, we will learn to divide the whole into equal parts and express it as a fraction. Appu asked Bunny to pluck some mangoes from the garden and bring it to his house. In return, Appu would give him such a big rectangle-shaped chocolate. On hearing this, Bunny agreed. When Bunny reached Appu's garden, he saw that the tree was very tall. Just then, Babban was passing by. He asked Babban for help. Babban told Bunny that he could pluck the mango by climbing up the tree. But in return, he would have to give him half of the chocolate. Children, do you know what half is? Suppose Bunny's chocolate is of such a rectangle shape. Now, if we divide it into two equal parts, like this, this part is one part of these two equal parts. We can also write it as a fraction in this way. Here, 2 is the total number of parts and 1 is one part of those two equal parts. We also call this half of this whole chocolate. Bunny agreed. Now Babban quickly climbed up the tree and plucked all the mangoes.
But what is this? How will both of them take these mangoes to Appu's house?
Neither of them has any basket or bag.
Look,
Chanda is passing by. She also has an empty basket. Babban and Bunny asked for her basket and told her the entire story. Chanda told them that she could give them her basket, but she wanted an equal share of the chocolate. So now they have to divide the chocolate into 3 equal parts. Children, can you tell how they can divide this chocolate into 3 equal parts? If you wish to, you may stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children. You have divided this correctly. Now, can you tell how can we express the parts got by each one of the 3 as a fraction? There are a total of 3 equal parts of the chocolate, and each one will get one part of it. Now, we can write it as a fraction in this way. We also call this 1/3 of the whole chocolate. In this way, all 3 will get 1/3 of the chocolate. Chanda also agreed and filled all the mangoes in the basket. But when they tried to lift the basket, it was too heavy and none of them were able to lift it. Just then, Bhola the donkey was passing by. Once again, Bhola also decided to help, and in return, he too asked for an equal share of chocolate for himself. Now, can you divide this chocolate into 4 equal parts? Write the part of the chocolate received by each one of them as a fraction. If you wish to, you may stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children! You have found the correct answer. We also call 1/4 as 1/4. Finally, the 4 of them reached Appu's house with the mango basket. Appu gave Bunny such a chocolate. He divided the chocolates into 4 equal parts, as found in the answer by you, and gave each of them one part of it. Children, in this lesson, we learned about dividing the whole into equal parts and how to write it as a fraction. In the previous video, we learned about dividing the whole into equal parts and how to write it in the form of a fraction. In this video, we will see some interesting examples related to this. One day, Chanda was walking in the garden. There, she found a letter. It was written in the letter that she would have to find some clues. And if she solves all the clues, she would find a treasure. Chanda got excited. She quickly read the letter further. It was written in it that first Chanda will have to find a window whose 3/4 glass is blue. Children, can you write 3/4 as a fraction? Yes, we can write 3/4 as a fraction in this way. Children, do you remember that here the number 4 shows that our whole is divided into 4 equal parts, and 3 parts out of them are blue. Now Chanda started looking for that window. She finally saw such a window. Are 3/4 of the glass in this window blue? You can stop the video to find the answer. Yes, your answer is absolutely correct. This window is divided into 4 equal parts, out of which 3 parts are covered with blue colored glass. In this way, 3/4 of the window has blue glass. Chanda found her next clue under this window. It was written in that clue that she would have to find a roof whose 2/3 part is made of yellow bricks. Children, can you tell what kind of roof will it be? Yes, it will be a roof which is divided into 3 equal parts, and 2 parts of it would be made of yellow bricks. Chanda started wondering where she had seen such a roof before. Then she remembered that she had seen such a roof over her friend Golu Panda's house. Chanda immediately reached Golu's house. If the roof of Golu house is of this shape, then can you divide it into 3 equal parts and fill yellow color in 2/3 of it? If you wish to, you can find the answer by pausing the video. Well done, children! In this way, we can fill yellow color in 2/3 of the roof. Now, Chanda found her last clue near Golu's house. It was written in that clue that she has to find a circle whose 5 parts out of 6 equal parts are pink in color. Chanda does not know what this circle will look like. Can you help Chanda by making such a circle? You can find the answer by stopping the video. Well done, children! You have made it perfectly. There are 6 equal parts here, and 5 of them are pink. We can write it as a fraction in this way. Chanda remembered from the picture you made that she saw such a circle-shaped clock in Uncle's house. She immediately reached Barbole Uncle's house. And there she saw that Barbole Uncle had brought her most cherished nut. Actually, he had hidden all these clues to give Chanda a surprise. Children, in this lesson we have seen some interesting examples of how to divide the whole into equal parts and how to write it in fractions. So children, in the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of how to divide the whole into equal parts and how to write it in fractions. In this video, we will learn about some misconceptions related to it. One day, Babban and the fox got lost in the forest. They had wandered a lot, but they could not find anything to eat. Both of them got tired and sat in the shade of a tree. Just then, they found a chapati there. Both of them became very happy. Now, both of them decided to divide the chapati in two halves. The fox divided the chapati in two parts like this and gave one part to Babban. Can you tell if the fox really gave Babban half of the chapati? Exactly! The fox did not give half part to Babban. The fox did not divide the chapati into two equal parts. So, the portion that Babban got was not half of the chapati. Children, if any object or shape is divided into unequal parts, then we cannot write it as a fraction. Fractions are made only from equal parts. The fox cleverly ate the larger piece of chapati. Now, while searching for the way out, they found such a rectangle-shaped cake. The cake was quite small. Babban understood that the fox had divided the chapati in unequal parts. So this time, he told the fox that she would have to make equal parts of the cake. The fox agreed. The fox split the cake into three equal parts in this way. The fox told Babban that she would eat two-thirds of the cake and Babban will eat one-third portion of the cake. When Babban could not understand, the fox wrote it in the form of a fraction. Children, the fox has divided the cake into three equal parts. But are they both getting equal amount of cake? The fox was once again fooling Babban. The fox has divided the cake into three equal parts, but Babban has got only one part, while the fox has got two parts. Hence, the fox has got more cake than Babban. The fox immediately ate two-thirds of the cake. Babban understood that the fox had once again made a fool of him. Now, while walking, they reached a marsh. Babban jumped up quickly and reached the other side of the marsh by hanging from one vine to the other. When the fox called out to him for help, Babban told her that when she finds the answer to how much is 2 by 0, then he will come to help her. Saying this, Babban left from there. Children, can we divide anything into zero parts? No. If there is an object, it will have at least one part. Because the whole of an object is equal to one part. Like, if we have this cake, we can write it as 1 upon 1. Meaning, this whole cake is one part and we are taking that whole portion. And zero parts means there is no part. And when there is no part, then how can we take two parts from it? The fox finally had to pay for her cunningness. Children, in this video, we learned about some misconceptions related to dividing the whole into equal parts and how to write it in fractions.
Hello children, in this video we will learn about equivalent fractions. Raju and Bablu are going to buy watermelon from the market. They bought a watermelon from Bunny's stall and took it to Raju's house. Now Raju told Bablu that he should divide the watermelon in two halves. Bablu cut the watermelon in two equal parts and gave one part to Raju. There are two equal parts of watermelon here, and both Raju and Bablu have taken a part of it. So we can say that both Raju and Bablu got 1/2, or half of the watermelon. Raju told Bablu that this portion is too big and he cannot eat it. So Raju cut those two big pieces into two equal parts. In this way, now the watermelon has four equal parts. Bablu gave two parts of them to Raju. Earlier, Raju and Bablu were getting one part out of two equal parts. And now, there are four parts of the watermelon, and they both are getting two parts. Children, is the amount of watermelon that Raju and Bablu are now getting more or less than before? If you wish to, you can stop the video and think about the answer. Absolutely right. Both are getting as much watermelon as before. Earlier, Raju and Bablu were getting one part out of two, that is 1/2 parts. And now, they are getting two parts out of four, that is 2/4 parts. Here, this one part is equal to these two small parts. And because the amount of watermelon they are getting is still the same, we can write that the fraction 1/2 is equal to the fraction 2/4. Such fractions that are equal are called equivalent fractions. Now Raju told Bablu that even now those pieces are quite big. Can he cut them into smaller pieces? Now he cut all the pieces from the middle and divided them into two pieces. Now, the whole watermelon is divided into 8 parts. And children, you can see, right? All these 8 parts are exactly the same. Now, if they have to take as much watermelon as before, that is, half watermelon, how many parts will Raju and Bablu get? Yes! Now, both will get 4 parts. That is, 4 parts out of 8. We can write the fraction of the watermelon given to Raju or Bablu in this way, as 4/8. Because both are getting 4 parts out of the total 8 parts. If you look closely, you will find that they are still getting half of the watermelon. So, we can write the fraction 1/2 is equal to the fraction 2/4 is equal to the fraction 4/8. All of these are equivalent fractions. Raju is now happy to see these pieces, and together they start eating the watermelon happily. Children, in this video we learned about equivalent fractions. In the previous video, we learned about equivalent fractions. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of this.
Today, Babban, Golu and Chanda have come to buy clothes from Barbole uncle's shop. Babban bought an 18-meter cloth of this design. Golu bought an 18-meter cloth of this design. And Chanda bought an 18-meter cloth of this design. When Babban reached his house, he thought, why not give 1/3 of his cloth to Golu and take a piece of the same length of cloth from him? In this way, they will have two different designs of cloth. Children, can you tell how Babban can make 1/3 of his cloth and how long will it be? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Absolutely right! In this way, Babban will cut his cloth into 3 equal parts and take 1 part from it. And that would be 1/3 of the cloth. If we divide 18 meters into 3 equal parts, each part will be 6 meters long. If you wish to, you may see. This first part is 6 meters. The second part is also 6 meters. And this third part is also 6 meters. 6 meters plus 6 meters plus 6 meters equal to 18 meters. In this way, this 1/3 part of Babban's cloth will be 6 meters long. Babban took 1/3 of his cloth and reached Golu's house. He told Golu his idea and Golu agreed. But there was one problem. Golu had already cut his cloth into 6 equal parts. Can you tell how Golu will be able to give Babban a cloth as long as his cloth? Let's see. Golu placed parts of his cloth like this and placed Babban's cloth's part just above it. Now he sees that 2 parts of his cloth are equal to 1 part of Babban's cloth. Do you think the same? This means 1/3 part of Babban's cloth and 2/6 part of Golu's cloth are equal. Let's look at it in another way. We saw in the beginning of the video that 1/3 part of Babban's cloth is 6 meters long. The length of Golu's cloth is also 18 meters. And he has made 6 equal parts of his cloth. So, how many meters will the length of one part be? Or how many meters will be 1/6 of 18 meters? 3 meters. But Golu has given 2/6 part to Babban. That is 2 parts out of 6. In this way, Golu has given Babban 2 times 3 or 6 meters long cloth. So you see, children, Golu has given Babban equal length of cloth. Here the lengths of Babban and Golu's cloths are the same. And 1/3 of Babban's cloth is equal to 2/6 of Golu's cloth. Therefore, these fractions are equivalent fractions. Babban took Golu's cloth and went to his house. While going home, he thought, why not replace 1/3 of his cloth with equal piece of Chanda's cloth? In this way, he will have 3 designs of cloths.
On thinking this, he immediately took one third of his cloth and reached Chanda's house. He told Chanda his idea too, and Chanda also immediately agreed. But Chanda had cut her cloth into 9 equal parts. Now, how will Chanda be able to give Babban a cloth as long as the part of his cloth? Chanda, just like Golu, placed parts of her cloth like this and placed Babban's cloth's part just above it. Now, she sees that 3 parts of her cloth are equal to 1 part of Babban's cloth. Children, is Babban's thinking correct? Are 1/3 part of Babban's cloth and 3/9 part of Chanda's cloth equal? Let us now look at it in another way. We know that 1/3 of Babban's cloth is 6 meters. The length of Chanda's cloth is also 18 meters and she has made 9 equal parts of her cloth. So, how many meters will the length of one part be? Or, how many meters will 1/9 part of 18 meters be? 2 meters. But Chanda has given Babban 3/9 part, or 3 parts out of 9. In this way, Chanda has given Babban 3 times 2, or 6 meters long cloth. Therefore, 3/9 of Chanda's cloth is equal to 1/3 of Babban's cloth. And these two are also equivalent fractions. In this way, 1/3 is equal to 2/6 is equal to 3/9. All these are equivalent fractions. Babban took 3/9 part of Chanda's cloth from her and happily returned home. Hello children! In the last video, we saw some interesting examples of equivalent fractions. In this video, we will learn more about it through some more interesting examples. Today, Raju and Bablu are playing a unique game. Raju will write a fraction. Then, he will write the number below the equivalent of that fraction. And Bablu will have to find the number above it. Raju first wrote this fraction. Bablu started finding the fraction. Children, can you help Bablu? Raju wrote this fraction. Here, the number 2 shows how many parts of a thing are created. And the number 1 shows that we took 1 of those 2 parts. Like, if we divide this circle into 2 equal parts and fill color in 1 part, then we can write the colored part of the circle in the form of a fraction in this way as 1/2. Now, in this fraction, the number 8 shows how many parts of something are made. In this way, we can make a similar circle and divide it into 8 equal parts. Now, we have to find out how many parts of these 8 parts should we take so that it is equal to half of the first circle. If we put these on top of each other, then we can see that 8 parts of this circle are equal to 2 parts of the first circle. And 4 parts of this circle is equal to one colored part of the first circle. Therefore, we will color in four parts of this circle. In this way, we have the numeral above our equivalent fraction as 4. In this way, half is equal to 4/8. This is Raju's next fraction. Children, can you find this fraction? Let's find it using a different shape. We can show this fraction by dividing such a strip into 5 equal parts and coloring 3 parts in it. Now, how many parts are there in its equivalent fraction? 15. Come, let us make a strip of equal length of this strip just below it and divide it into 15 equal parts. Now, if we put this strip on top of the first strip in this way, we will find that 15 parts of this strip are equal to 5 parts of the first strip. Can you now tell how many parts out of 15 are equal to 3 colored parts of the bottom strip? Let's see. Yes, 9 parts. In this way, 3 by 5 is equal to 9 by 15. This is Raju's last fraction. Children, can you find this last fraction? If you wish to, you may find it by stopping the video. Well done, children! You have found it absolutely right. If we take 2 equal length strips and divide one of them into 3 equal parts and the other into 12 equal parts, and then put the second strip on top of the first strip, we will find that 3 parts of the first strip are equal to 12 parts of the second strip. And if we look closely, 8 parts of the second strip is equal to 2 colored parts of the first strip. Thus, 2 by 3 is equal to 8 by 12. With your help, Bablu found all of Raju's fractions. See how he is happily dancing. Children, in this video we learned more about equivalent fractions through some more interesting examples. Hello children! In the last video, we saw some interesting examples of equivalent fractions. In this video, we will learn more about it through some more interesting examples. Today, Raju and Bablu are playing a unique game. Raju will write a fraction. Then, he will write the number below the equivalent of that fraction. And Bablu will have to find the number above it. Raju first wrote this fraction. Bablu started finding the fraction. Children, can you help Bablu? Raju wrote this fraction. Here, the number 2 shows how many parts of a thing are created. And the number 1 shows that we took one of those 2 parts. Like, if we divide this circle into 2 equal parts and fill color in one part, then we can write the colored part of the circle in the form of a fraction in this way as 1 by 2. Now, in this fraction, The number 8 shows how many parts of something are made. In this way, we can make a similar circle and divide it into 8 equal parts. Now, we have to find out how many parts of these 8 parts should we take so that it is equal to half of the first circle. If we put these on top of each other, then we can see that 8 parts of this circle are equal to 2 parts of the first circle, and 4 parts of this circle is equal to 1 colored part of the first circle. Therefore, we will color in 4 parts of this circle. In this way, we have the numeral above our equivalent fraction as 4. In this way, half is equal to 4/8. This is Raju's next fraction. Children, can you find this fraction? Let's find it using a different shape. We can show this fraction by dividing such a strip into 5 equal parts and coloring 3 parts in it. Now, how many parts are there in its equivalent fraction? 15. Come, let us make a strip of equal length of this strip just below it and divide it into 15 equal parts. Now, if we put this strip on top of the first strip in this way, we will find that 15 parts of this strip are equal to 5 parts of the first strip. Can you now tell how many parts out of 15 are equal to 3 colored parts of the bottom strip? Let's see. Yes, 9 parts. In this way, 3 by 5 is equal to 9 by 15. This is Raju's last fraction. Children, can you find this last fraction? If you wish to, you may find it by stopping the video. Well done, children! You have found it absolutely right. If we take 2 equal length strips and divide one of them into 3 equal parts and the other into 12 equal parts, and then put the second strip on top of the first strip, we will find that 3 parts of the first strip are equal to 12 parts of the second strip. And if we look closely, 8 parts of the second strip is equal to 2 colored parts of the first strip. Thus, 2 by 3 is equal to 8 by 12. With your help, Bablu found all of Raju's fractions. See how he is happily dancing. Children, in this video we learned more about equivalent fractions through some more interesting examples. Children, in this video, we will learn to identify and compare fractions. Golu has got a cloth of this design to Chacha's shop today. He wants to get a trouser stitched for himself. Children, can you tell how many sections are there in the design of Golu's cloth? Yes, 12 sections. Now, can you tell how many yellow colored sections are there in the design on Golu's cloth?
If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Yes, in Golu's design, 6 sections are filled with yellow color. Let us write it as a fraction. Yellow colored sections are 6/12 of the design. Children, you remember, right? The number 12 tells us that our total cloth is divided into 12 equal parts. And 6 tells us how many parts of it are yellow. Can you write the number of red colored section in the design on Golu's cloth as a fraction? Find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Oh wow, children! You have found the answer absolutely correctly. The red colored section is also 6/12 part of the design. While Golu was standing at uncle's shop, Chanda came there. She saw the design made on Golu's cloth and liked it very much. Now, she's asking uncle if uncle has any such design cloth which has a total of 15 sections. Of them, 7/15 should be blue, 5/15 pink, and the remaining sections should be green. Children, here 15 means the cloth will be divided into 15 equal parts. Let us see how uncle fills color in it. Then uncle showed a white cloth with 15 sections like this. Can you fill color in this cloth according to Chanda's design? Let us first fill the blue color of Chanda's design. Chanda needs blue color in 7/15 section. In other words, 7 out of 15 sections have blue color. We can fill it in this way. Now, can you fill 5/15 sections in this design with pink color according to the design given by Chanda? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children! You have filled the color perfectly. You can fill pink color in 5/15 parts of Chanda's design in this way too. Children, can you tell how much part of the design are the remaining sections that have to be filled with green color? You can find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Yes, green color is in 3/15 part of Chanda's design. Children, can you tell what color is the largest part of Chanda's design? Let us look at the number of parts of all the three colors. The total number of parts in the fractions of all the colors is exactly the same. Therefore, we will look at the numbers of parts filled with colors. Number of blue colored parts here, 7 is the highest. Hence, the biggest part of the design, 7/15, is filled with blue color. So, the fraction 7/15 is bigger than both of these fractions, 5/15 and 3/15. Children, if we have filled blue color in 2 parts out of 15 parts, pink color in 7 parts, and green color in 6 parts, can you then identify the largest of these fractions? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children! You have found the answer correctly. The largest fraction here is 7/15. Chanda's cloth is ready with her design. Look how happy she looks. Children, In this lesson, we learned to identify and compare fractions. Hello children! In this video, we will see some interesting examples of identifying and comparing fractions. Babban does a lot of mischief with all the people in the village. Today, he has come to buy sweets at Appu's sweet shop. He could not decide which sweets he wants to buy. So Appu divided the sweet box into 10 equal parts like this. Now Appu put Kaju Katli, Laddu and Peda in the sections in this way. We can write the different sweets filled in the box in the form of fractions in this way. Which sweet is filled in the largest part of the sweet box? And in how many parts? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Absolutely correct! Laddus are filled in the largest part, 4/10 of the sweet box. When Babban saw the box of sweets, Appu had filled peda in some parts. Chanda had told him that Appu's pedas are not tasty at all. So, he asked Appu to fill jalebi in parts of the box where he had filled pedas. Appu was a bit irritated as his shop was starting to get crowded. He quickly filled the jalebi in the parts where pedas were filled. Children, can you tell how many parts of the box is jalebi filled now? You can find the answer by pausing the video. Yes, jalebi is filled in 3/10 parts of the box. When Babban looked at the box of sweets, he saw that there are 2 sweets that are filled in equal parts of the box. Can you tell which sweets are these? And how many parts of the box are they in? Well done, children! You have found the answer correctly. Both jalebi and kaju katli are in 3/10 part of the box. Babban remembered that Chanda loved laddus. So, he asked Appu to fill the laddus in the parts where kaju katli was filled. Now, Appu started getting angrier. But still, he filled laddus instead of kaju katli. Can you tell which sweet is now in the largest part of the box and in how many parts? If you want, you can stop the video and find the answer. Correct! Laddus are filled in the largest part of the box, 7/10 part. Now Appu's shop was very crowded. Just then, Babban told him that he no longer needed jalebi and he should also fill laddus in place of jalebi. Appu became very angry and asked Babban that which sweets did he really want. Then Babban told him that from the beginning he wanted only laddus, which are now filled in all parts of his box. Babban started laughing out loud on saying this. He immediately gave Appu the money for the laddus and ran away. Poor Appu once again succumbed to Babban's mischief. Children, in this video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying and comparing fractions. Hello children! In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying and comparing fractions. In this video, we will see some misconceptions related to this. Today, Appu and Chanda are celebrating their birthday together.
A 1 kg cake like this has been brought to celebrate Appu's birthday. And a small 500 gram cake of exactly the same design has been brought for Chanda. Both cut their respective cakes into 5 equal pieces. Appu gave one piece of his cake to Raju and Chanda gave one piece of her cake to Bablu. Now, Raju told Bablu that he and Bablu had got equal cake. But Bablu is fighting with Raju that Raju has got more cake than him. Children, can you tell which of the two is correct? Let us first look at the cake that Raju and Bablu got in the form of fractions. Raju got one piece out of 5 equal pieces of Appu's cake. Hence, Raju got 1/5 part of Appu's cake. Bablu got one piece out of 5 equal pieces of Chanda's cake. So, Bablu got 1/5 part of Chanda's cake. The fractions of the cake that Raju and Bablu got are the same. But is the amount of cake they got also the same? Appu's cake is 1 kg or 1000 grams. Now, if we divide it into 5 equal parts, then how many grams is each part? Exactly. Every part is 1000 divided by 5 or 200 grams. In this way, Raju got one portion of Appu's cake or 200 grams of cake. Now, Chanda's cake is 500 grams. If we divide it into 5 equal parts, then how many grams is each part? Each part is 500 divided by 5 or 100 grams. In this way, Bablu has got one part of Chanda's cake or 100 grams of cake. Children, now can you see that Raju has got 200 grams of cake and Bablu has got 100 grams of cake? Even though the fractions of the parts of Raju and Bablu's pieces are the same, the amount of cake that Raju got is more than the amount of cake that Bablu got. Therefore, Bablu's statement is correct. Children, remember that even if the fractions of the parts of two objects are the same, but if the quantity of those objects is not equal, then those parts will not be equal. When Bablu explained this to Raju, Raju jumped with joy that he got more cake than Bablu. Now Appu and Chanda have made delicious sandwiches for all the party guests. Appu cut the sandwich into 6 equal pieces like this and gave Raju one piece or 1/6 part, while Chanda cut her sandwich in 2 equal parts and gave Bablu one piece or 1/2 part. Now Raju once again started teasing Bablu that he got 1/6 part of sandwich and Bablu got 1/2 part of sandwich. And because 6 is a larger number than 2, he got a larger portion of the sandwich. Children, is Raju's statement correct? Appu and Chanda's sandwiches are exactly the same size. Raju got 1/6 part of the sandwich and Bablu got 1/2 part. If we put Raju's piece on Bablu's piece,
we will find that Raju's piece is actually much smaller than Bablu's piece. But why did it happen? Children, if we divide any object into equal parts, as we increase the total number of parts, they become smaller and smaller. Similarly, in 1/6, we have made a total of 6 pieces of the sandwich, whereas in 1/2 parts, we have made only 2 parts. Therefore, a piece of 1/2 part is larger than a piece of 1/6 part. Or we can say that the fraction 1/2 is greater than the fraction 1/6. Therefore, Raju's statement is not correct. Raju became depressed after knowing this. Seeing Raju sad, Bablu broke a piece of his sandwich and gave it to Raju. They both happily ate the sandwich and started enjoying the party. Children, in this video we saw some misconceptions related to identifying and comparing fractions. Hello children, in this video we will learn to compare fractions. Today a competition is going on in the village. Uncle has scattered a total of 36 pieces of paper in a rectangular area here. All the contestants will be given 1 minute time in the competition. The contestant who writes his name on the most pieces of paper will win the competition. Babban, the moderator of the competition, indicated the start of the time and all the contestants quickly started writing their names on pieces of paper. Time is up and now the counting has begun. On counting, it was found that Golu's name is written on 1/3 part of the total paper pieces, Sher Khan's name on 2/9 part and Bhola's name on 4/9 part. Children, can you tell who is the winner of the competition? Let's first find out how many pieces of paper has Golu written his name on. Golu's name is written on 1/3 part of 36. Children, can you tell how many pieces will these be? Here, 3, this number tells us how many equal parts to divide our whole into. And 1, this number indicates that out of 3 parts, we have to take 1 part. Here we have 36 as the whole. If we make 3 equal parts of 36, then how many pieces will be there in each part? Absolutely right. 36 divided by 3, or 12 pieces. In this way, 1/3 of 36 is 12. Golu wrote his name on 12 pieces of paper. Now Sher Khan has written his name on 2/9 parts of 36. Can you tell how many pieces of paper has Sher Khan written his name on? Is it less than Golu's pieces or more? If you wish to, you can stop this video and find the answer. Well done, children. You have solved it perfectly. For 2/9 of 36, we will divide 36 into 9 equal parts. In this way, each piece will have 4 pieces of paper. And in 2/9, we are taking 2 of these 9 equal parts. There are 4 pieces of paper in 1 part of this fraction. So, how many pieces will be there in 2 parts? 2 multiplied by 4, 8 pieces of paper. In this way, 2 ninth of 36 is 8 pieces of paper. Sher Khan has written his name on a total of 8 pieces of paper. Golu has written his name on 12 pieces and Sher Khan has written his name on 8 pieces of paper. Therefore, Golu has written his name on more pieces of paper than Sher Khan. We can also look at it in this way that the fraction 1/3 is bigger than 2/9. Children, can you tell how many pieces of paper has Bhola written his name on? Are these more or less than the pieces of paper on which Golu has written his name on? You may find the answer to this question by pausing the video. Well done, children. You have found the right answer. Bhola has written his name on 4/9 parts of 36. For 4/9 of 36, we will divide 36 into 9 equal parts. In this way, each part will have 4 pieces of paper. And in 4/9, we are taking 4 of these 9 equal parts. There are 4 pieces of paper in one part of this fraction. So, how many pieces will there be in 4 parts? 4 times 4, 16 pieces of paper. In this way, 4/9 of 36 is 16. Bhola has written his name on 16 pieces of paper and Golu has written his name on 12 pieces of paper. Therefore, Bhola has written his name on more pieces of paper than Golu. We can also see it in this way that fraction 4/9 is larger than 1/3. We can also write the fractions for the number of pieces of paper written on by Bhola, Sher Khan and Golu in this way. After all, Bhola won the competition by writing his name on the most pieces of paper. Children, in this lesson, we learned to compare fractions. Hello children! In this video, we will see some interesting examples of comparing fractions. Babban has sown 12 pumpkin seeds in his field. A few days later, he saw plants growing from those seeds. Babban became very happy. Now, Babban started thinking that when 12 pumpkins grow out of those plants, he will give 1/4 of them to Barbole uncle. He makes very tasty pudding of pumpkin. Children, can you tell how many pumpkins Babban will give to uncle? In 1/4, we have to divide our whole into 4 equal parts. Here, we have a total of 12 pumpkins. So we have 12 pumpkins as our whole. We will divide them into 4 equal parts. If we make 4 equal parts of 12 pumpkins, then how many pumpkins will be there in each part? Exactly 3 pumpkins. Now, what will we do to get 1/4 part? Take one part out of these 4 equal parts. In this way, 3 pumpkins are 1/4 part of 12 pumpkins. Babban will give 3 pumpkins to uncle. Now Babban is thinking that he will give 2/3 part of 12 pumpkins to Chanda as she is his best friend.
Can you tell if Babban will give more pumpkins to Uncle or Chanda? You can find the answer by stopping the video. Well done, children! You have found the perfect answer. First, we will find the number of pumpkins that Chanda gets. To find 2/3 of 12 pumpkins, we have to divide 12 pumpkins into 3 equal parts. In this way, there were 4 pumpkins in each part. Now, to find 2/3 parts, we have to take 2 parts out of these 3 equal parts. In this way, 2/3 of 12 pumpkins is 8 pumpkins. Babban will give 1/4 part of 12 pumpkins or 3 pumpkins to Uncle and 2/3 of 12 pumpkins or 8 pumpkins to Chanda. In this way, Babban will give more pumpkins to Chanda. Children, in other words, we can say that the fraction 1/4 is less than 2/3. Babban returned home happily thinking of this. Now, he is at home thinking that he will grow 20 carrots in his field. When those carrots are grown, he will give 2/5 part of it to Bunny and half to Golu. Children, can you tell how many carrots will Bunny get? Is that more than the number of carrots Golu gets? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children! You have found the perfect answer. To find 5 parts of 20 carrots, we will divide 20 carrots into 5 equal parts. In this way, there will be 4 carrots in each part. Now, to find 2/5 part, we have to take 2 parts out of these 5 equal parts. In this way, 2/5 parts of 20 carrots will be 8 carrots. Babban will give 8 carrots to Bunny. Let us see how many carrots will Babban give to Golu. To find half of 20 carrots, we have to divide them into 2 equal parts. And then, 1 part has to be taken from it. In this way, 10 carrots will be half of 20 carrots. Babban will give 8 carrots to Bunny and 10 carrots to Golu. Hence, Bunny will get lesser carrots than Golu. In this way, we can see that the fraction 2/5 is less than half. Babban became happier thinking about all this. Now, Babban is thinking that when he sells his vegetables in the market, he will get a lot of money. Out of that money, he will buy 25 laddus with some money. Out of those 25 laddus, he will eat 3/5 of it in a single day. Can you tell how many laddus will he eat in a day? You can find the answer by pausing the video. Well done, kids! Your answer is absolutely correct. To find 3/5 of 25 laddus, we will first divide the 25 laddus into 5 equal parts. In this way, there will be 5 laddus in each part. Now, to find 3/5, we will take 3 parts out of these 5 parts. In this way, 3/5 of 25 laddus are 15 laddus. Babban fell asleep thinking about laddus. Children, in this video, we saw some interesting examples of comparing fractions.
Hello children, in the previous video we learned to compare fractions of objects through some interesting examples. In this video we will learn about some misconceptions related to this. This time there has been a very good crop in the fields of Babban, Bunny and Chanda. The three of them thought, why don't they collect some of their respective crops and together make something delicious? There are 100 corns grown in Babban's field, 30 carrots are grown in Bunny's field, and 70 tomatoes are grown in Chanda's field. Babban said he would give 1/5 of his corn. Bunny said he would give half of his carrots, and Chanda said she would give 1/7 of her tomatoes. The three gathered their vegetables and made a delicious dish from them. Now, when it came to distributing the dish, Bunny said that because half is more than 1/5 and 1/7, he should get half of that dish. But Babban is saying that he has given the most vegetables. Therefore, he should get the largest part of the dish. Children, who do you think is right? Babban or Bunny? If we only compare fractions, we will find that Bunny is right, because half is greater than 1/5 and 1/7. But here, these are different items whose quantity is also different. Like half of 30 carrots, 1/5 of 100 corns, and 1/7 of 70 tomatoes. The amount of vegetables of Babban, Bunny and Chanda are different. Therefore, we cannot tell who has given more vegetables by just comparing the fractions. So, what shall we do now? To solve the confusion between the three of them, we have to find out the number of vegetables given by each of them. Here, the total quantity and share of vegetables grown in the crops of Babban, Bunny and Chanda is written. Can you find the number of vegetables given by all three from these parts? If you want, you can stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children. You have found the right answer. Babban gave 1/5 of 100, or 20 vegetables. Bunny gave half of 30, or 15 vegetables. And Chanda gave 1/7 of 70, or 10 vegetables. Babban has said the right thing. He has given the most vegetables for the dish. Therefore, he should get the largest part of the dish. Babban explained this to Bunny and Chanda in the same way, and both of them understood. But Babban said that he does not want the biggest share. The three together happily shared equal portions of the dish and ate it with fun. Children, keep in mind that we can compare fractions of two objects only if the wholes of those objects are the same. As we know, the fraction half fraction is more than the fraction 1/5. But if we talk about 1/5 of 100, which is equal to 20, and half of 30, which is equal to 15, then we can see that half of 30 is smaller than
1/5 of 100. Because their holes are not the same. Therefore, to compare fractions, we must pay attention to fractions as well as their whole. Children, in this video, we learned about some misconceptions related to comparing fractions of objects.